Good morning, this is Paul Turner, the immigration barrister at Imperium Chambers. Please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on any immigration news and views. Following up on my last video about the Home Office having been found to have broken the law in respect of trying to identify modern day victims of slavery, things have got worse for the government, which comes as no surprise to anyone that watches this channel, because the High Court have made a very important ruling. They've ruled that the Home Office's policy on granting leave and rights to work to potential victims of trafficking was unlawful. Mr Justice Mostyn found in the case of EOG versus the Secretary of State for the Home Department, found that the government policy, which actually failed to provide any route or leave to remain to those that are the potential victims of trafficking and their inability to work, he found that policy to be unlawful. Why? Well, the reason for this was, perhaps unsurprisingly to anyone who watches this channel or has any dealings with the Home Office, is that this was due in no small part to the Home Office delays, which meant in reality that potential victims often lost their right to work before their applications or to be considered as modern day slaves were actually considered. This is obviously patently absurd and offensive and goes against the whole prospect of protecting people. If the Home Office are going to delay in making decisions, and this is not limited to trafficking, if you look at the delays in making asylum decisions, the latest figures show over 76% of cases took longer than 6 months to process, which is the government's target. The court noticed in respect of the trafficking case that there were delays at every stage of the process. This is just not me ruminating on the failures of the Home Office, but the concerns of numerous bodies, including the ATLEU, and Callaghan, who do fantastic work for people who are at the very margins of society. The consequences of these delays are that the lack of any leave to remain or right to work for people in the NRM was harmful to their recovery, discouraged them from agreeing to be referred in the first place, not surprising, and potentially put victims at risk of re-exploitation because they've got nowhere else to turn. Mr Justin Mostyn, in a very clear and striking judgment, found as follows. There is an unlawful lacuna in the existing policy, in so much as it fails to implement the obligation in Article 10.2 of the European Convention Against Trafficking, formally to protect persons in receipt of a positive reasonable grounds decision from removal from this country's national territory, pending conclusion of the process. The Home Office must formulate a policy that grants such persons interim discretionary leave on such terms and conditions are appropriate both to their existing leave positions and to the likely delay they will face. Well, is there much of a delay? Well, let's go on and find out. The judge was particularly critical and went further in what should be done and why. Someone in the position of a claimant who has a time-limited right to work should not have the arbitrary adverse consequence of a removal of a right, that right to work, meted out to her simply by virtues of the delays that she is likely to face, and I would add, and she has no control over. In the case, he heard that it was found that there had been delay of some 800 days or more for a final decision. That might not sound much in the context of an asylum claim, but in respect of trafficking, the government's supposed to make a final decision within 45 days and a preliminary decision within 5 days. The judge said that there had been a remorseless increase in delays, which lamentably had gone from bad to worse. What makes this worse is this contradicts the assertions made previously by the Home Office to the court last year that matters were improving in respect of the time limits, in respect of the way people were treated, which led to another judge in the administrative court basically taking the Home Office at its word, which I would always say is a very dangerous thing to do, and dismissed the application. Perhaps if the judge last year was presented with the facts as they stand today, the judge would not have refused the application. It's quite clear that the government will say or do anything and change its mind to avoid losing. Unfortunately, no matter how much Priti Patel and the Home Office wriggle, they seem to be keep biting the hook or keep getting caught out. This again is a lamentable failure on behalf of the Home Office, and it's good to see that the High Court have stepped in yet again to protect the rights of the very most vulnerable people. And this is to be borne in mind that contrary to what you could possibly imagine if you're sitting in the United Kingdom, there are masses of slave markets in Libya where people are bought and sold for a few hundred pounds or a thousand at most. Thank you very much for watching. This is Paul Turner, the Immigration Barrister at Imperium Chambers.